Once you start collaborating within Microsoft Teams, it might be a good idea to check out the settings and configure your profile. Creating a team in Microsoft Teams is one thing, but once you get started, it's pretty evident that there are some settings you want to configure. How things are notified. Have you got a nice little picture next to your name like your co-workers? Or are you just happy without the cheesy grin like Megan Bowen? And you're just happy with the initials depicted from your username? Changing this is quite easy. All we got to do is go up to the top right-hand corner of the screen. The top right-hand corner of the screen with the current blue circle you can see at the moment that relates to my icon. Now, this icon, as you can imagine, is pretty boring. It's not as dynamic and as provoking as the ones with people's faces or pictures. Now you can add a picture or an icon, but there's so many more other settings here. You can set your availability, whether it be busy, do not disturb, appear away, or back to available. You can look at your message status, and you can set this for a determinate period of time. We used to be able to do this within Skype, and of course you're all familiar with the out of office within Microsoft Exchange and in other mail solutions. This could be pretty good. Hey, I'm just popping to the dentist, you know you're going to be an hour. Set it for an hour, and then instantaneously you're going to be, it'll change back to available. The message will clear itself, and then you'll be there available to be collaborated with within this platform. A great functionality, and it's seldom used. You can also check out saved messages, either messages that you've saved or, you know, your private conversations with your colleagues. But the real key here is the settings menu. Not only can you set your themes to high contrast for those using LCD displays or with some sort of eye defect or special eye restrictions, or you can set it to the dark theme. And the dark theme, everyone's got a dark theme now. Windows got one, Facebook got one, Workplace has got one. Dark is great. It's really easy on the eye. Notifications. These basically tend to be what notifications you're going to get and in what format. All configurable, but manage notifications is quite compelling. This is where you can track somebody, like what you used to be able to do in Skype for Business, when they come online or go offline. This is great. Keep an eye on the boss. Is the boss in? The boss is online. Ping. There you go. There's your notification. The boss is offline. Party on, Wayne. And then, for example, you might want to know when one of your colleagues has come online, so you want to collaborate with them. So this is a good way of putting a notification and letting Microsoft Teams let you know when they're around. And this has been able to be done within Skype for Business for quite some time. So moving on, what we got next? So you can download different versions of the app, and I'm using the web app here on the test tenant. You got the about section, which you can look at privacy and cookies and alike. And going back to settings, the final section, which deals with notifications and also languages you can set as well within the client. Now, privacy is a great little section. This lets you know who can punch through your restrictive availability settings. So if you're set to do not disturb or you're presenting, you might want to be contactable by the next presenter. Hey, I'm here. Or hey, guess what? It's the boss, you know, and see me now. You may want your boss to be able to connect you and punch through that one availability setting regardless of what your status is. And that functionality will let you do it. Now we talked about the pictures. Changing your picture is quite easy. You click on the top right hand column. You click on change my picture. You then select the picture or icon that you want to depict yourself within Microsoft Teams. You say upload. You click on save. And then you are done. As you can see, the collaboration kernel icon is what I've set for the administrator within this particular test tenant. But it could easily be a small picture thumbnail or an icon depicting a department, or whatever you really want to put in there, pictorial, for example. And that's how I'm going to be portrayed within Microsoft Teams. Now, it's a good thing having these pictures. They say a picture speaks 1,000 words, and that the brain processes pictures 60,000 times quicker than it does words. So looking down a list to see a picture of one of your co-workers to whom you know can be quite a compelling way of collaborating, as can seeing what they look at before you meet them. And we work in a very global space these days, but you might not meet people who you work and talk to every day. This can be you know, change with video conferencing and the like, but at least you'll have some sort of vague idea of what that person looks like. And that all sort of, like, how can I put it, helps you collaborate a bit better. It brings people closer together in that sort of virtual office environment. I've been the Collaboration Kernel, and this has been a look at the profile settings. Like and subscribe if you haven't done so, and check back for more videos in this series. Thanks for watching.